VC, the Waxed here, and in this video, I'm going to do an unboxing. I just got my hands on the Sade box this far. Now, I know this came out a year ago, and it sold out, and because of the pandemic, the price jacked up high on this. But it recently was repressed and became available, and the price went down. And that's when I came in and got my copy using coupons. And if you guys aren't using like your browser extensions like Honey, which tells you when prices drop on items, you guys got to get them. And there's also those sites like Retail Me Not and Fat Coupon that you can sign up, and when you go to a site, they'll give you percentage back on what you bought. So that's a lot of the ways I try and be thrifty or cheap when I buy stuff. So I picked this up through Walmart, and I got a good deal on it, and I want to open it first. I want to show you that I do have two OGs of Sade. I have Diamond Life. Nice. And this sounds beautiful. It's like minty. Same here with The Promise. Shout out to Deep Track Zach. He hooked me up with this one. But, you know, as watching videos of people talking about this, it's hard to get. There's six all their albums are here on this. And there's a foam insert. When I open this up, we'll see it. It has a place, supposedly, for their next album. But, this has already been out for a while. And I know there were some pressing issues with this, and so hopefully, since it's been repressed, they've addressed all those issues. Thank you. So what I do is I'll take my handy-dandy scalpel Exacto knife, and I'll cut right into here and open it. Let's take away... the pressure's off, and just open. So, and pull away this and this. All right, so we have it, and I kept that adequate hype sticker there on there. There's no extras at all with this, just the albums. So let's pull them out in order, I suppose, or pull them all out and see what I got myself into with purchasing this. So first I'll show you this foam insert, which has a giant question mark on it. So all we can assume is they have an album they've been working on for a while. I know they did a couple songs for some soundtracks. That's what they've done in the last bunch of years. But that's pretty much all the band has done. Has a nice smell to it. Okay, let's start off with Diamond Life is here, and it is a gatefold. Let's pull out the old Diamond Life first, shall we? So we can look at it. Whatever version I have is not a gatefold. It does have the insert inside, which I'm guessing is the same as the gatefold. So the paper insert from the OG is inside the inside of the gatefold. And I don't know, maybe some people could say, do you have a gatefold of this? Okay. Shitty paper sleeves. Shitty. Okay, that's the downside so far. Come on, people. All right. Static. This looks very clean, wherever it was pressed, and flat and nice. But, Epic label, Patriot label. And I believe this, it's a division trademark of CBS. I think I have an American pressing of this, so interesting. You Must Go. So this paper sleeve has to go, and I need to put it in a, I don't have them handy nearby, so. But that's interesting that this is on this Epic label, and the OG's on the, I'll pull it over again, portrait, not patriot. What am I talking about? I'm a moron. Thank you. You all agree. That's interesting. I don't know, but it's a division that says it's division of CBS, so maybe later presses. Someone will chime in. Let's get down to business. You don't want to hear me just babble on, like, of information I'm guessing about, but let's put this back in this horrible, shitty paper sleeve. This jacket is nowhere near nothing special. It's very average at best, so you're not getting... I mean, I guess you're just going to be thankful. Be honest, I paid under $100 for this. I think when it was came out initially, it was like $180 and whatever it was. But again, let's just do side-by-side look. I'd say about the same. Font's the same. But gatefold, non-gatefold. Okay. You're sick of listening to me. Okay, let's go with the next one. The Promise, so I can compare it. Here's The Promise, and it is not a gatefold. So we're on portrait again on the second one. And I actually have this in a vinyl storage solution sleeve. So it's not a gatefold. And this isn't the same album. I'm a dork. This is how you don't shoot a video, guys. Here it is, Promise. And it is a gatefold. There's the gatefold on Promise. So I'm guessing if I take this out of my vinyl storage solution sleeve, which I will do now, I'm gonna guess the insert inside. I'm hoping I have the insert. I do not have the insert. I'm guessing the original insert that came with this is what the gatefold is. If anyone out there has an OG of this with the insert, can please confirm based on Diamond Life. I am making an educated guess. And you guys can tell me that my guess is good. All right. But nice gatefold here. So I guess that's a plus. Same kind of cheapy cover. Let's pull out this shitty paper sleeve. Shitty. And I'm guessing this is probably Epic and not portrait. Very staticky. Different white Epic label here as opposed to there, the OG I have. So I don't know how late into the pressing that they changed, but there you go. Very unimpressed by the records are like 180 gram. They're nice and heavy. So, all right, that being done, let's move on to the next one, and we'll do an order that makes sure it's stronger than Pride. I have CD of this. I had CDs of all of these. Okay. Now, not a shitty paper sleeve. The sleeve is the insert. Okay. So, and it's a printed, so it's better, I guess. Let's see if it did any damage. No. There you go. On that white Epic label there. So that's nice. Okay. I know you're going, well, I saw these people do an unboxing of this a year ago. Tough, I'm doing it now. Okay, next is, the one I have a CD of, Love Deluxe. And I will say, so far, this is the best cover. It's textured. It's gorgeous. That picture's gorgeous. And there they are on the back. And so far, I mean, The others are, you know, have a matte, glossy matte finish, but this is textured and paper, and this is nice. So I will say nice. And another inner sleeve with the printing on it. And I guess this one they changed. Let's turn it around. There you go. Nice. On Epic. Haha. Seam split. Come on, people. Sony. Come on, get your crap together with this horrible, horrible shipping and seam splitting and all that nonsense. Okay, we got one left. Soldier of Love. So we're all in here so far. No, Lover's Rock. Where'd you go? I've moved everything around. There you go, Lover's Rock. Dude, I don't prepare for these videos. It's so obvious. All right, another inner sleeve. No seam split on it. Let's see. Nice. So far, I will say this vinyl is clean. Now, I haven't listened to it yet, so obviously nice and clean. There you go. I'm very impressed how clean. There's not even no paper burn, no chemical kind of crapola that you usually can wash off. So I am impressed by the cleanness of the records. We'll see. I'll crack one of these open and play it. They're all cracked open. Okay, let's go with the last one here. Man, I'm horrible at this, aren't I? This is Gatefold, and it's about to do some AMSR. That was kind of like a little toot fart. Yeah. So let's pull this out. Let's show you the inside here. There you go. And what I'm hearing is people say these last three albums, which are hard to get on vinyl, do sound very good. You know, I did watch the Ingrooves video of unboxing, and he was going through all the OGs of the original three that he has. But this is, look at that. That label's nice. This is nice. And again, clean vinyl. Nice. Very impressed by that. Gorgeous. So the paper sleeves, you know, come on. What people are paying. And again, actually, compared to the Love Deluxe, these last three are all kind of textured, papered, printed, and very nice. So I will say that. The first three, you know, okay. And these last three are nice. So I'm not too unimpressed. I will say, just on the unboxing, obviously I'm repeating myself. Paper sleeves, come on, people. What are we, in the 20th century? But, you know, the negatives are no extras, which it's fine. There's no seam splits or anything on here. Just that one inner sleeve on one of the albums had a little split thing. But so far, so good. I'll report back. After I listen to these, I don't want to get a copyright infringement on this one. I just wanted to do unboxing. But, hey, run out and get it right now as I record this video. It's like $137 on pretty much Amazon, Walmart, most places. And then if you can get a coupon or use one of those sites that give you a percentage back, you can lower it down. Definitely worth $100 what I spent on this, so I'll say that much. And if you guys have any comments based on my less caffeinated prepping for all this, please leave comments below. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you like, if you want more videos of this, please leave a comment. Thumbs up if you like it. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Until next time, the Waxed Out.